Hey, how's it going? Welcome back to ThinkView, and this is NK. The ThinkPad X1 Carbon is always a premium business laptop, or I should say hyper premium, because of its price is always higher than other on the market. And the Gen 13 version I have here costs up to $2,500. But do you think it's worth such a sky-high price, or are Lenovo just being delusional with their pricing? Let me know your thought in the comment down below, okay? Alright, now let me break it down to you whether you are paying for the real value of this laptop or just for the ThinkPad name. Okay, let's get started. So first, let's talk about the face value of this laptop. What really makes up its value? The most impressive thing about the X1 Carbon Gen 13 is its material. For many users, this might be the unique selling point of this ultrabook. The whole chassis is made from a material that is a mix of magnesium and carbon fiber, making it ultra light, yet still ultra durable. And I'm using the X1 Carbon Gen 12, which is already feel very light at just 1.12 kilograms. But the Gen 13 is even lighter at just 970 grams. That number doesn't feel real at all. You will not know how light it is if you just looking at it. Lenovo didn't make the chassis ultra thin though. It still have enough thickness to feel solid. So the fact that Lenovo can make this laptop weigh less than a kilogram proves that they've used some seriously high-end materials. And thanks to that extra thickness, Lenovo was able to include a full set of I/O, from USB-A to Thunderbolt to even HDMI, and that's basically everything you would need. Overall, the design is still very much ThinkPad, clean, professional, giving you a very business vibe. And I really like that little notch here that make it easier to open up the lid. I also love the hinge, which makes the opening smoother than Lenovo Yoga laptop in the lower price tier. Now, talking about the touchpad and keyboard, there are two versions of the touchpad that are available for the Gen 13. The first version has the haptic touchpad that exactly the same one that I have with my Gen 12, and the other has the traditional mechanical touchpad, like on this Gen 13 that we have at the studio. I think that many businessmen still prefer the classic one, which is probably why Lenovo still kept the traditional version. And as for the keyboard, this is still one of ThinkPad's strongest points. It follows the classic ThinkPad design. It got slightly curved keys with deep key travel and soft but tactile feedback. And overall, typing on this feels really good. Another highlight is the screen. You get an OLED 2.8K at 120Hz refresh rate display. And all the numbers speak for themselves. Almost 100% coverage of all three color gamut, from sRGB to DCI-P3, and even Adobe RGB, with the overall brightness of 410 nits being just the cherry on top. The OLED panel on this laptop is also treated to reduce glare in compared to regular OLED screen. And at the same time, the colors are also slightly toned down, which make it look more natural. And this panel delta E is only 0.55, which means the color accuracy is super high. Now talking a little bit about the security feature, as a business laptop, this laptop got you covered with both fingerprint reader and facial recognition through Windows Hello. And it's also come with a camera cover. Performance-wise, this laptop runs on the Intel Core Ultra 7 258V, which in my opinion is the final piece of the puzzle that make this a true premium Windows machine. You can clearly see that the previous ThinkPad with the old Intel chip always have some kind of heat issues or battery issues, but with this one, it's totally a game changer. It's run cool and quiet, and especially for office work and multitasking, you won't even hear the fan kick in. Now, for battery life, under daily usage scenario, I got around 7.5 hours at 250 nits of brightness and 60 Hz of refresh rate. And yes, 250 nits is quite bright in the case of office usage, but the battery life is more than enough for working at the cafe or outdoor. And when you go indoor, you can lower the screen brightness to get even more usage time from this laptop itself. The SSD inside is the Gen 5 SSD, which is lightning fast. Opening app is instantly, and if your job related to moving large files from here to there, you will know exactly what I mean. This version is also come with 1TB of SSD and 32GB of memories. Now, talking about performance, especially for those using Premiere Pro, then rendering time is improved quite a lot. Especially for basic daily log, then this machine can handle it all. But you can't compare with other MacBooks both in terms of performance and quietness. You see, when rendering with maximum power, the fans get noticeably loud. I mean, honestly, using the X1 Carbon Gen 12 to do rendering is like asking me to do weightlifting. I mean, it can do it, but only when you really need it. On the gaming aspect, well, this laptop can run AAA title at full HD pretty good, and effortlessly with esport title, so gaming isn't much an issue here. Alright, if all the above confuse you, then I have a summary in just one line. If you need a Windows laptop that is also top tier premium, then the X1 Carbon Gen 13 would likely be your best option. And that's why Lenovo sets such a high price for this thing. Now, let's talk about the other value starting from the brand itself, ThinkPad. So ThinkPad has always been a valuable name. Ever since the 90s, this lineup has been the first choice for business users, as it's always associated with durability. Even now, Lenovo still continue to put all of their effort into improving this machine with the best material, bringing the best user experience. Things like the iconic track point and even the premium pricing are all the part of how ThinkPad positioned themselves as a cut above the rest. Now, to be fair, let's compare this laptop with others. Now, if we look at the MacBook Pro 14, I'm pretty sure that most people would pick it, but not everyone can or even want to use macOS. And after all, macOS is still have less than 20% of market share. So now if compared to Dell or Razer, well, they can't even stand the value or reputation either. The user experience isn't as satisfied as before. Or you can take the HP Elite Dragonfly as an example. The material aren't any special. Maybe only the Surface laptop is still okay, but it doesn't feel business in this design. In general, the X1 Carbon Gen 13 may feel unreasonably expensive to most people. But for a specific group of customer, like a businessman who doesn't care much about the price, it's perfectly checked all of their boxes. These people just want a high-end Windows laptop that works flawlessly, no annoying issue, just snappy and premium experience. And that's where the X1 Carbon Gen 13 really shines. It's beautifully crafted, compact, and portable. It has a gorgeous display. It has all the connectivity that you would need, and most importantly, solid security feature. So now, if you look at this laptop price as around $2,500, I would say that price includes both the face value and the name value of the ThinkPad. So what do you think? Is this price tag justified for all of the experience that this laptop got? Let me know in the comment section down below, okay? And don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you won't miss any upcoming videos about the latest tech. Now, thanks for watching. This is NK from ThinkView, and see you guys next time.